Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question comes in from our Facebook group. So if you go to Facebook and search for MrExcel.com, you'll find our company page there. There's like a few discussion posts. Hey, look at this. We have 935 fans. Isn't that cool? So we can come here, and there's some discussion threads. And Sheryl posted a great question that I described in detail on the Facebook page. But I want to show you how to do this. I'm back in Excel 2003 because Sheryl is in Excel 2003. We're going to create a pivot table from this data, pivot table, and click Finish. And we'll apply maybe region, product, and then let's do our quantity, revenue, cost of goods sold, and profit. Okay, now, my suggestion to Sheryl was that she was going to record a macro that's going to make life easier. She talked about formatting these region totals, and you might have a different number of intervening rows here, so you can't just copy the formatting from the old pivot table. Now, before you record a macro that's going to operate on a pivot table, you need to change the name of the pivot table. That cannot be in the macro. So we're going to go to pivot table, table options, and I'm going to call this BillPT for pivot table. Click OK. All right, now when we record the recorded macro is always going to work on BillPT. Now, here we go. Tools, macro, record new macro. I'll call it format my pivot. Shortcut key Control Shift P stored in this workbook. Great. All right, the macro recorder is now running. Now, here's my tip for Sheryl. I said we start out above the pivot table. You see the white plus sign there? But I want to go to the very first region total and then to the left edge of that region total. So right there, bam. See it change from a white plus to a black horizontal arrow? So white plus, black horizontal arrow. When it's a black arrow, click, and you're going to select all of the region totals, wherever they may be. Now I can apply any formatting. So I want those region totals in green, bold, maybe 11-point font. I also suggested Sheryl should right-click Table Options and uncheck Auto Format Table. She talked about how frustrating it is that the columns widths change every time that she adds a new field. So click OK. And now we will stop recording. Okay, so on another day, click Delete. And we come in, we create our pivot table. It'll be a slightly different pivot table this time. Data, pivot table, finish. Still going to put regional on the left-hand side, but now I'm going to put customer in the region field, and some different fields here, revenue, cost of goods sold, and profit. Drag the data to go across. Okay, here's the big test. First thing we have to do, pivot table, table options. Remember that name, BillPT. Click OK. Now we should be able to run the macro, which is going to operate on the pivot table called BillPT. It should go through to the region totals and format those. So let's run Alt F8. And it's called Format My Pivot. Click Run. Check it out. Even though there are far more rows here with customer instead of product, it was smart enough to go through and find all the region totals and format those. Very, very cool way to go. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.